In this video, I'm going to show you how to clean out the hot end on your Ender 3 version 2 or any other printer that doesn't have an all metal hot end. If you're having problems with stringing or clogs, or just simply keep seeing the previous color filament come through when you're printing, then it may be time to clean your hot end. All you'll need for this are the tools that came with your 3D printer and ideally some sort of heatproof glove. I use a leather rigger glove, which is cheap to buy and does the job. Firstly, heat up your hot end to the hottest temperature you've heated it to since you last cleaned your hot end. This is to make sure that you're going to melt any leftover filament that's still in there. If you've never cleaned the hot end before, then just heat it up to just above the hottest temperature you've printed with. If you're using the standard white Teflon tube that came with your Ender 3, then don't heat it up to the maximum temperature because this Teflon tube doesn't actually survive the heat very well for very long. Remove your filament as I showed you in my video on loading and unloading filament, or alternatively do a cold pull. Adjust up your Z height to about 120mm using the move function. Undo your fan housing by removing the bolt in between the rollers on the back. As you remove the fan cover, you may have to clip a cable tie and pull back the sleeving to be able to move it all out of the way. The next thing is to remove your nozzle. This is where you have to start being careful as you're dealing with very hot parts. Put on your glove and decide where you're going to put the hot nozzle when it comes out. Pop off the little silicone cover off of the heat block. If there's any filament left on the nozzle, clean it off now as it's much easier than when it cools down. If you have a lot of material on the outside of your nozzle, use a damp cloth or even a brass wire brush. Don't be too heavy-handed with the brush though, because brass nozzles do actually wear out quite easily. Now is also a good time to run the nozzle cleaning needle through the middle of the nozzle to clear out the hole. It was at this point that I found that the spanner supplied with my printer didn't actually fit the nozzle. The best tool to use here is actually a socket wrench rather than an open-ended spanner. This way you never actually have to touch the hot nozzle and you won't round off the nozzle if your spanner does fit. I've put a link to these wrenches down in the description, but just check the size of your nozzle before you buy, as they can come in different sizes. Once you're happy that your nozzle is as clean as can be, then undo it. Hold your heat block still with an adjustable spanner or something similar that will hold it still without damaging it. Most of these heat blocks are only aluminium, so it's very easy to damage them. If you're not sure which way to turn the nozzle, it needs to go anti-clockwise as you look at the end of the nozzle, which of course most of us won't be. If you're looking from this kind of angle, turn the end of your spanner or wrench to the left. Unscrew the nozzle all the way and remove it. You now have about 30 seconds to clean off any excess material on the threads or the back of the nozzle before it cools down. Don't worry if you don't get it perfectly clean though, we'll put the nozzle back in a way that won't damage anything. Now if all you're doing is changing the nozzle, you can just put a new nozzle back in, but we're going to clean our hot end before doing that. Remove the retainer clip on the pneumatic fitting on the top of your hot end, and then try to remove the Bowden tube by pushing the clip down with a small spanner and pulling the tube up. If the tube doesn't release, which quite often they don't, then undo the pneumatic fitting and withdraw the whole thing. If your Bowden tube did come all the way out, then undo the fitting now. As you withdraw the Bowden tube, you may find that some filament on the end. This is good, this is what we're trying to get out, so just take a damp cloth and wipe it off. If not, don't worry, we're going to push it all out in a minute anyway. The next thing we're going to do is take a length of this Bowden tube and push it all the way through your hot end. So if your pneumatic fitting is still on the tube, you need to remove it now. So now take either the end of your Bowden tube or a spare piece that you may have and push it all the way down through the hot end so it comes out the bottom. Wipe off anything off the bottom before you retract the tube, or if you're using a spare piece, just push it all the way through and clean it off. If you're getting a small cylinder of filament coming out of your hot end, this would have been causing you printing issues with either stringing or under extrusion. If nothing's coming out, then your hot end is clog free. This is good. Have another go just to make sure everything that's in there is out, and then your hot end is clean. If you're enjoying this video, then let me know by hitting like, and if you want to see any new videos I do, hit subscribe. I make regular content to help people like you with 3D printing and other projects. Now before we reassemble, we're going to check a few things. Make sure the end of your Bowden tube is clean, undamaged, and cut straight. If it's not perfect, then trim a little bit off the end using either a purpose-made cutter or a Stanley knife. It's important that the end of the tube is cut straight so that it fits up squarely to the back of the nozzle and doesn't leave any gaps. Now with everything still hot, we're going to refit your nozzle. Gently thread the nozzle in a couple of turns, only enough so it doesn't drop, but don't thread it all the way in just yet. This is so that the nozzle heats up and any leftover filament on it melts before you ram it through the threads. After about 30 seconds or so, you can screw it all the way in, but then when it gets tight, back it off one complete turn. We're not going to do the final tighten until the Bowden tube is in, pressed up against the back of it. Now fit the pneumatic fitting back into the top of the hot end and nip it up. Now would be a really good time to replace this fitting. The standard ones are notoriously bad, and you can buy much better ones at a very cheap price. Again, links down in the description. If you want to print with higher temperature filaments like PETG or ABS, then now would be a good time to replace the Teflon Bowden tube with a Capricorn tube. You wouldn't get away with printing with the standard Teflon tube for long, and there's no downsides to upgrading to the Capricorn tube other than the cost of purchasing it. Again, obviously links are in the description. But if everything is working okay, then there's no reason why you can't just refit the Teflon tube in the standard pneumatic fitting. Push the Bowden tube down through the pneumatic fitting firmly until it comes to a definite stop. Now reattach the retaining clip. If you've upgraded to the better pneumatic fittings, they're really tight to put on, but they will go and will hold the fitting in place. Now go back to your nozzle and tighten it up while holding the heat block still again with an adjustable spanner or something similar. Once your nozzle's tight, refit the silicone sleeve to the end, being careful not to burn yourself. This method of tightening the nozzle up after you've put the Bowden tube in just again ensures that there's a nice tight fit between the back of the nozzle and the Bowden tube and there are no gaps for filament to get into. Refit your fan cover and load your filament and you should be ready to go. Let me know down in the comments if you've successfully used this method for cleaning your hot end, or indeed if you've had any issues. Click here if you want to see another video relating to the Ender 3 version 2, or click here for another video you might find interesting. Thanks for watching.